Hare Krishna. Our urges aren't like endlessly rising lines. They are like endlessly recurring waves. Surf them patiently. Sometimes when we try to resist some temptation, some urge that rises within us, and we find that urge keeps getting stronger and stronger and stronger. And then we may feel that this urge, how long can I fight it? Its strength is just increasing. And we feel that the strength is going like this, like this, like this, is going up, 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 up. And eventually it will become so strong that it will overpower me. However, that is an illusion, that is a misconception. The urges are not like endlessly rising lines. They rise, 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 but then they are actually like the waves. It crests and then it starts going down. And then after some time, another crest comes. Again it rises, again it goes down. So our urges are like waves. And each wave is independent of the previous wave. So it's not that each wave builds on the previous wave. So one wave may be huge and it might just toss us helplessly. But that doesn't mean the next wave is going to be bigger than that. So it's waves, and these waves, we just need to surf them. So when the wave comes, if we can, okay, what does surf, to be swept away by the wave means? To get caught and lose control and get away. But to surf with the wave means we are alert, we spot the wave and we stay above the wave. We note, okay, it has come, it's rising, I am also rising. And that means we just don't get carried away by the wave, but rather we stay on the wave. That means we stay as the observers, and as it rises, 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 if we remind ourselves, I am an observer, I am a soul, I am not this desire, I am the observer of this desire. Then, yes, desire is increasing, 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 but no matter, so just as when we are surfing a wave, as the wave rises, we will also rise higher. But as long as we are on the wave and with the wave, we won't be swept away by the wave. We just have to stay on the wave. That means we have to stay as an observer of the rise of the urge. And eventually, the crest will come and it will start going down. So becoming an observer is what the Bhagavad-Gita recommends in the 14th chapter. It says that in 14.22 and 23, Prakasham cha pravrittim cha mohameva cha pandava nadveshti sampravrittani nanivrittani kaṅkṣati. It's udasi navadasinam gunayo navichalyate gunavartantityeva yogatishthati nengate. So it says this desires, so different kinds of desires will come within us because of the influence of the modes. But udasina vadasinam, just stay as if detached, stay as an observer. Gunayo na vichalyate, knowing that these are just the waves induced by the modes. Stay as an observer. Gunavartantye tyeva, understanding is nothing more than the modes. Yo avatishthati nengate, don't shake, don't flinch, don't fear. Just persevere. And what will happen by this? We will go be, the wave will subside, the crest will give way to the trough. Now, one way could be that you just observe the wave and just outride it, just ride it. Another way is that we are observing the wave, but we also turn our consciousness towards Krishna. That's what here Krishna recommends later when he says, just become fixed in devotion to me. By observation of the urge, without getting carried away by the urge, and by connection with Krishna, who exists at a higher spiritual level, we can surf the urges till eventually the waves break and die. And then we steadily reach the coast of eternity, the coast of eternal ecstatic love for Krishna in his abode. Mamchayo vyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevate sagunan samatityaitan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. That's what Krishna promises in the Bhagavad Gita in 14.26. says if you stay fixed in him, it will transcend this material existence. Hare Krishna.